Today's patient wants to be empowered. They don't want to be told what to do. And so if we educate them and empower them with really solid information, they're more likely to make a decision that's going to be best for their future.
If a woman is considering coming to Waterleaf, you're going to be able to make your decision. We're not going to stop you from making your choice. However, you need to be educated.
Our patients know before they even get here that we don't provide for or refer for abortions. We're very clear with them when they make the appointment. We're here to do a screening service for them and give them all the options that they need. So when they get here, they're already fully aware of that.
I help identify if there's any reason that they have an emergency situation that they should be seen by someone right away versus doing what we do here. Perform pregnancy tests, STD testing. I make sure that they understand and consent for ultrasound and that they know what that would mean.
Our patients, when they come to us and have a chance to see that ultrasound screen, that window to the womb, it is priceless.
The visual aspect of that is huge for a patient. When they can visibly see that there is life going on, it taps into an emotional connection for them that maybe they're not going to get by just having a positive pregnancy test.
So often in society, women are told, well, it's just a clump of cells. Well, when they see that ultrasound, they realize there is no truth to that. It is a baby. There is a beating heart. You're a mother already.
You've got time to breathe. You've got time to talk. You've got time to pray. You've got time to wrap your hand around all the facts before you make that final decision that you can never come back from.
And then at the end of the appointment, after they've had their ultrasound, I meet with the patient again, make sure they understand how far along they are, what that means as far as the development of their pregnancy. If they are abortion-minded or abortion-determined, I go over with them what procedures they are most likely to encounter, what those procedures really are, what the risks and side effects to those procedures are, and make sure that they understand that so that we don't inhibit their ability to choose, but we certainly make sure that they make an informed choice.
So when a client comes to us, most likely they've already been seen on our medical side at Waterleaf. They've had a chance to breathe and really digest the fact that they're pregnant. And once they've had that chance to breathe, they can really dig into what's out there for themselves. And what they are looking for are some resources. Many of our clients are low income, they might not have insurance. So we are there to kind of navigate them through the process and direct them. If we can't help them, we can typically direct them to places that can. So we're able to walk with them on their journey. Some of the challenges they're facing and in need of, a lot of times it's housing. Many times it's financial. They need the medical card. They don't know how to navigate that. Oftentimes, you know, it's information. It's just classes, how to be a parent. Our classes aren't just about parenting. They're also about life skills and budgeting. There's a full range of their needs. We can also get them in touch with places that do grants. So if they fall behind on a bill while they're pregnant or up to a year after having their baby, they qualify for a grant. So another extended program that we have is our mom-to-mom mentoring program. They'll do things like cook them a meal, take care of their other child while they go to a doctor's appointment, drive them to a doctor's appointment. Some of them have even gone as far as had a baby shower for these women, and then they'll walk with them even after they've had that baby. I would want our clients and our patients to know that Waterleaf is a safe place for them to get education. If they do choose abortion, we are there for them. We will do post-abortive counseling. We will do grief counseling if someone miscarries. So I want them to know it's a safe place where they're respected and loved.
It is of utmost importance to us that our patients leave here feeling respected, are never belittled, never questioned, just informed and empowered.